the 15th, which is answer B. Problem number six, taking a look at that problem, it says that, let me scroll up here, it says the average value of a certain type of computer was $1,500 in 1994 and depreciated to $900 in 1999. Let Y be the average value of the computer in the year X, where X equals zero represents 1994. Okay, write a linear equation that models the value of the computer in terms of the year X. Well, if 1994 is year zero, then we have a point that in year zero, it was worth $900. Oh, sorry, in year zero, 1994 is worth $1,500. And in 4 years, 5 years later, in 1999, it was worth $900. Okay, so let's write down these points that we have here from this. So one point that we get here, again, was that in year zero, which is the year 1994, but the X value would be zero, the computer was worth $1,500. And another point is that 5 years later, that would be the year 1999, it depreciated to $900. Well, we got 2 points, and if you have 2 points, you can get the equation line. We're looking for the equation line in that slope-intercept form, like y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope. So we got to figure out the slope first. And to get the slope, we find out how much it rises over how much it runs. Well, how much did it rise? Well, it didn't rise. It fell. It went from 1,500 down to 900. So I'm going to say 900 minus 1,500. And then how many years went by? Well, let's take 5 minus 0. And if I do that right here, 900 minus 1,500, I get negative 600. And that's 5 on the bottom. And dividing those, you get minus 120. So that's the slope of this line is minus 120. In other words, it's depreciating $120 every year. Now look, when I subtract here 900 minus 1500, make sure you do 5 minus 0, not 0 minus 5. So you got to subtract in the same order here. So at this point, we know the slope is negative 120, and we have y equals minus 120x plus b. The b is the y-intercept, and on this particular problem, it's given to you right here. This is your y-intercept, because when x is 0 and you're given 2 points, then the y part of it is your y-intercept. So the equation would be y equals minus 120x plus 1,500. And that would pretty much do it on this problem right here. So let's go ahead and look at 7. And on problem 7, it says this. It says r over 4 and 1 over s is equivalent to r divided by 4. Well, I'll say equals r divided by 4. Oh, here, this is pretty tough. R divided by 4 divided by something. Okay, divided by what? That's what it's asking for. What divided by what? Well, divided by what here? Well, see, r over 4 times 1 over s is the same as r over 4 divided by s. Because if you remember from maybe dividing just regular fractions here, this is s over 1. And when you divide, what do? Well, you reciprocate this second fraction and multiply. So in other words, r over 4 times 1 over s is the same as r over 4 divided by s. So the answer to this is just s, and that's choice C. And I'll pick it up from here on the next video.